Welcome back. In the previous lecture, we worked on basic SIP registration with one softphone. In this lecture, we'll integrate multiple QSIS softphones with a real SIP proxy to get a deeper understanding of the typical setup of the proxy itself and what we need to know about that setup to be successful in registering and making calls. In an advanced setup, CUCM supports registering up to 8 softphones per device. We'll discuss this more a bit later. A quick review of the basic topology of a typical VoIP deployment is shown above. Everything here stays the same when we're working with multiple softphones instead of only one. Keep in mind, the topology here is greatly simplified from an actual enterprise VoIP deployment, but the basic concepts shown here should apply to any running CUCM implementation. Again, the first step for most SIP telephony endpoints is to register with the SIP proxy. In this case, CUCM checks the credentials of each endpoint and responds accordingly. The endpoints can make calls when and only when they're registered with the call manager. We'll discover that different methods are required to interface QSIS to CUCM depending on the number of QSIS softphones required in your project. Previously, we focused on one softphone only. In this workshop, we're going to focus on multiple softphone registration. In a future workshop, we'll address SIP trunk integration. Next, we will configure a system with multiple softphones. The steps to configure this are similar, but slightly different in CUCM and for the QSIS softphone. First, we create the security profile that will be used for the softphones. This is shared by all of the softphones. Next, we create the end user profile that includes the credentials the softphones will use to register. These credentials are shared by all of the softphones too. Finally, we create the phone definition, which consists of a device and the associated directory numbers. The directory numbers are the phone numbers used for the softphones. Let's look at each step in detail. When multiple softphones are required in a QSIS design, they need to be registered as third-party SIP device advanced. As before, the very first part of defining the softphones in CUCM is to create a phone security profile. We can skip the details of each field as we saw them in our previous workshop. The user ID in the end user setup corresponds to the authentication username in the QSIS softphone setup. This user ID will be shared by multiple softphones in this setup. Again, the authentication password is set in the Digest Credentials field. The password will be shared among all of the softphones as well. The final step is to configure a phone device of the correct type tied to that user account. We see here the device is set up as an advanced third-party SIP device. We also see here how multiple directory numbers will be associated to the same device. Here, we see the device type again showing it is configured as advanced. As we saw in the basic setup, we also need to add a digest user on the device screen. This will match what we configured earlier. In this example, it would be QSIS1. In the protocol-specific information at the bottom of this page, we assign the device security profile we created for an advanced phone. The SIP profile will be the same as it was for our basic phone. The very last element to tie in is the directory numbers associated with this account. In this case, you can see that we have 4 directory numbers assigned and 4 spaces for additional directory numbers if needed later. On the core side, most things remain the same, except that for each softphone, you want to configure it to use a different username. This will correspond to the directory numbers that were configured in the previous step on CUCM. For example, if we had 4 softphones, the usernames might be 1001, 1002, 1003, and 1004. The authentication ID and password will all be the same. Now, if we go back to the core, we should see all 4 of our softphones registered. One of the common issues that sometimes occurs is that the extensions are set up as basic and not advanced. Recall back to our earlier slide where we set up a third-party SIP device advanced. If for some reason we accidentally configured our extensions as a basic device instead, we'd see something strange happen. One line will register, but the other will stay in fault. Then you might see the other line register and the first one fault. Why? Because a basic device only allows one line to register. If we go back to CUCM and change it to advanced, then it should work again. At this point, you should be able to open each softphone and see the same OK status as before when we only had one. You also can try to place a test call from each softphone. You can even call one softphone from the other. That's it. At this point, you should have multiple softphones registered to your CUCM. Stay tuned for our final workshop where we will discuss SIP trunking.